goodness. Oh, where? Okay, so if we were here, but then we went there, and now we're here again. Oh, I'm just so confused.
Hey, G, what do you got there?
Oh, hey, Pastor Carl. I'm just looking at God's big story timeline right now, and I'm just a little confused.
Okay, well, maybe I can help you. What are you confused about?
Okay, well, the order of God's big story timeline doesn't seem to be the same as the order in my Bible. I mean, we were learning about Moses back here, and then we learned about the tabernacle.
Yep.
But then we all of a sudden started learning about Jesus.
Yeah.
And then we went back to the Old Testament after that and learned about people like David and Jonah. I'm just a little confused.
I see. Well, that's easy to explain. Here on Kids Church TV, we started learning from the beginning of the Bible in books like Genesis and Exodus.
Okay, okay.
Right? See, you were with us for that?
Yeah. And okay. So, but then what happened like around Christmas time? What did we do there?
We definitely wanted to celebrate Jesus at Christmas because that's what we love to do. Christmas was all about Jesus' birth. So even though it wasn't the very next story in the Bible, we wanted to take some time to celebrate that special message of Christ's birth. So we jump to Christmas.
Okay, okay. I think I'm understanding this now. And then I see we're going to jump to Easter as well.
You got it. Yeah, we love to celebrate big moments. And Easter is a huge moment for us because that's the time we remember Jesus' death on the cross and then celebrate that he came back to life.
Okay, okay. I think I got it now. So God's big story timeline is just what we call our teaching time here on Kids Church TV, but it's not actually the exact order of how things happened in the Bible.
You got it. And now that you've got that, we got to get going because we got a special episode today.
Oh, yeah, we do.
Yeah, here on Kids Church TV. Hey, I'm Pastor Carl. This is Mr. G. Welcome to Kids Church TV. Hey, boys and girls, and welcome to a special great day here on Kids Church TV.
We are so glad that you could be with us today. And as you just heard, it's a special day today. And the reason for that is because today we're doing things a little bit differently.
We're still going to sing and worship, but today there will be no new big idea and no new memory verse and no new Bible teaching either. Today we are doing a whole lot of rewinding and a ton more rejoicing.
Instead, we're going to take a look back at some of the wonderful things that we've learned so far on Kids Church TV.
It's going to be a really fun episode today, and we're going to see how much you boys and girls can remember.
Okay, okay, well, let's head over to the studio right now, and let's get to our first rewind for today.
Let's go!
All right.
All right, so we're going to see if we can remember some of the big ideas that we've learned over the last little while, and this is how we're going to do it. G?
Okay, so we're going to put up a chart with some of the big ideas that we've done over the past couple months since our last Rewind episode. The game is for you to try and remember what the Bible story was for each of those big ideas. So you'll see the big ideas and you gotta try to remember what Bible story we learned for that big idea. The chart will look like this.
Okay, if you're in a classroom right now, we want you to split up into teams and have one teacher or leader get a piece of paper and something to write with for each team. If you're watching at home or somewhere else, you can get one of your parents or an adult to help you and get a piece of paper so that you can write some of the things down. It'll help you.
Okay, and we're going to put up 2 minutes on a clock. 2 minutes. One, two. And during this time, we want you to try and connect as many of the big ideas to the stories that you can remember. All right? So you're going to see big ideas. You're going to tell us what the story was. All right? Are you guys ready?
2 minutes.
Pastor Carl, are you ready?
I'm ready. Two
all
minutes.
Right. Let's put our 2 minute clock up and let's go.
All right. I wonder how many of those you could remember.
I could remember like Whew. Three.
Time to find out how many they remember. Can you count how many you got right?
All right, and it wouldn't be a rewind episode if we don't actually rewind to some of those amazing big ideas.
For sure. All right,
ready? Let's rewind.
Drum roll, please. Jesus is the promised one. Drum roll. Jesus comes to us. Drum roll. God is with us.
Oh.
Drum roll, please. God's faithfulness never ends.
Drum roll, please. God always wins.
Drum roll, ready, G?
Ready? I'm ready, I'm ready.
God's love is steadfast. Mm. Drum roll, God reigns over all. Drum roll, please. God is great and there is no other. Drum roll, please. God cleanses us.
Drum roll, please. God forgives me.
Drum roll, please. God is our righteousness.
Drum roll, please. God blesses obedience. Drum roll, please. Ooh, that was weird. God rescues us. Wow, my brain hurts seeing so many big ideas. We've learned so much about how amazing God is.
Yeah, well, now comes our next little challenge game, memory verses.
Boys and girls, how many memory verses do you think you can remember and say that we've learned since our last rewind episode? We're gonna tell you where they are in the Bible, and you'll try to say them out loud to your teacher or your leader or whoever you're at home with right now.
Okay, so here they are. Let's see our memory verses right now. There's four of them. You see them right there. Okay, ready? 2 minutes and go.
All right, I wonder if you could remember any of those memory verses. Some of them are tricky, but it's time to find out, all right? Let's rewind.
Matthew chapter 1, verse 21, and it says this: "She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." Deuteronomy chapter 20, verse 4, it says this: "For the Lord your God is he who goes with you, to fight for you against your enemies, to give you the victory." Isaiah chapter 44, verse 6. It says this: "Thus says the Lord, I am the first and I am the last. Besides me, there is no God."
1 John chapter 1, verse 9. It says this: If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins.
Oh, those are some good verses right there.
They sure are.
Hopefully the kids, the boys and girls watching, were able to remember maybe at least one of them.
I hope so.
Yeah. Okay, right now, boys and girls, wherever you are, stand up with us and let's worship our amazing God. Come on, let's stand up. Let's sing to God right now.
I'm gonna jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. 'Cause jumping says I love you. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jumping says I love you. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jumping says I love you. I'm gonna dance to show Jesus just how much I love him. Dance to show Jesus just how much I love him. Dance to show Jesus just how much I love him. 'Cause dancing says I love you. Dance, 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 dance. Dancing says I love you. Dance, 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 dance. Dancing says I love you. I'm gonna spin to show Jesus just how much I love him. Spin to show Jesus just how much I love him. Spin to show Jesus just how much I love him. 'Cause spinning says I love you. Spin, 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 spin. Spinning says I love you. Spin, 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 spin. Spinning says I love you. I'm gonna shout to show Jesus just how much I love him. Shout to show Jesus just how much I love him. Shout to show Jesus just how much I love him. 'Cause shouting says I love you. Shout, 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 shout. Shouting says I love you. Shout, 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 shout. Shouting says I love you. I'm gonna sing to show Jesus just how much I love him. Sing to show Jesus just how much I love him. Sing to show Jesus just how much I love him. 'Cause singing says I love you. Sing, sing, sing.
Okay, well, now we have something really exciting to get to. If you saw our last Rewind episode, you'll know exactly what we're talking about. But even if you didn't, you're going to find out right now.
If everyone's ready, let's send it over to reporter Rick's favorite person in the whole wide world.
Game show Ricky.
Game show Ricky.
Hi there, all you wonderful boys and girls. How are you doing today? Okay, well, I can't really hear you. I can't hear them. Are they there? They can hear me. Okay, they can. Good, excellent. Well, welcome, boys and girls, to the Review Report. I am your delightful host, Game Show Ricky. For those of you who haven't seen our game show before, it's really quite simple. I'll ask you some brain rocker questions that have to do with something that you've learned in God's big story. You'll give me your answer, and if you're right, I'll give you points. How many points, you may ask? Well, that's entirely up to me, Game Show Ricky. All right, any questions? Well, I don't see any, so let the games begin. Okay, let's show these youngins our Wheel of Trivia. We will spin this cool-looking wheel, and it will land on one of three choices: big ideas, memory verses, or big God story trivia. I will ask you a question that has to do with one of those categories, and you will have 15 seconds to answer the question. If you are in a classroom, you can split into teams with a teacher or a leader in each team. If you are playing at home, you can have a parent or adult that you are with help you keep score. Do that now while we go to a commercial break. And we're back, ready to go. I don't know about you kids, but I can just smell the excitement. Yes, I have a very strong sense of smell. Moving on, before each question, we are going to all say this together. Ricky, spin that wheel. You got it? That's what we're going to say. Okay, let's practice. Say it with me. Ricky, spin that wheel. Not bad. Did you say it? I hope so, because we're about to start. Time for our first spin, so say aloud with me, kids. Ricky, spin that wheel. Oh, goody. God's big story trivia. Here's the question. Who led God's people, the Israelites, into the promised land? Was it Moses, Joshua, Abraham, or maybe Noah? Who was it? Ready? Start that clock. All right, hope you got your answer, because here comes the right one. It was Joshua. Okay, so if you got that answer right, you get 5 points. Okay, we are on our way now. Time for another spin, so say it with me, kids. Say, Ricky, spin that wheel. Well, hold my lucky charms. It's time for a memory verse. Okay, so this will be a fill in the blank, so you have to tell me what the missing word is. Are you ready? Okay, let's see the verse. Isaiah 44:6. Thus says the Lord, I am the first and I am the last. Beside me there is no blank. There is no what? Are you ready? Okay, let the countdown begin. Wow, 15 seconds goes by fast when you're counting backwards. Let's see the answer, please. It's God. Thus says the Lord, I am the first and I am the last. Besides me, there is no God. That's just beautiful. And if you got that right, you got yourself a cool 10 points. On to question number 3. Can you show me 3 fingers? Yep, that's right. I can see them. Not one, not two. But 3. Well done. Okay, so now you know what to do, kids. Say, Ricky, spin that wheel. Heyo, it's time to see your ideas about our big ideas. You see what I did there? Okay, can we see the question, please? We learned at Christmas time something very special, that Jesus is the blank one. Jesus is the what one? That word starts with a P and it's not pineapple. Ready? Okay, start the clock, guys. And just like that, 15 seconds is up. And the answer is, Jesus is the promised one. The answer was promised. And wow, what a promise Jesus is. And Jesus always keeps his promises because he is God. Let's see how many points for that one. Let's go with 7 points if you guys got that right. Well done. Numero 4. Let's spinner. You know what to say, kids. Come on, say it with me. Ricky, spin that wheel. Yes! More trivia. I just love it. Okay, for 5 points, here's your question. who was a shepherd boy who became king of Israel? Was it Samuel, Elijah, David, or Pastor Carl? I have a strong feeling I know which is not the right answer there, but hey, it's your choice. Let's start the clock. Okay, and stop. I'll tell you now, of course, the answer isn't Pastor Carl. The right answer is David. David was a shepherd who became king of God's people, the Israelites. 5 points for all your correct answerers. Is that a word? Sure, let's go with it. Okie dokie, eat some artichokes. Let's spin our trivia wheel. What do we say, kids? Say it with me. Ricky, spin that wheel. Okay, let's think big here. What does God bless? You learn that God blesses something. What is it? Here's a hint. You learn this in a story about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And go! Pencils down. Are you even using pencils? I don't know. Who knows? But I know the answer is obedience. God blesses obedience. When we listen to God, he blesses us. Wow. That's wonderful. 7 more points if you got that right. Oh, silly conca. Do you boys and girls know what that means? It's time for our lightning round. I will read 5 questions, and you will have just 5 seconds to answer each one. You gotta listen fast, because I'm gonna talk quickly. Here we go. In what book of the Bible is this verse found? If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. The correct answer is 1 John. How many times did Naaman have to bathe in the river? 7. Who was swallowed by a big fish? The correct answer is Jonah. Fill in the blank. Here we go. Deuteronomy 20, verse 4. For the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to give you the blank. To give you the what? The correct answer is victory. Why were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego thrown into the fiery furnace? What did they not do? The correct answer is they did not bow down to worship a golden image. Whew! I am kind of sweating. That was pretty intense. Can anybody help me out here? Thank you. That was refreshing. Okay, for each question you guys got right in the lightning round, you can give yourselves 5 points. Well, kiddos, it's time to count how many points you got and to see how well you did. Just know that this was all just a fun way to help us rewind and think of some of the wonderful things that we've learned so far in God's big story. So remember that Jesus loves us so much that he died for us so that if we believe in him and trust in him and love him, he saves us and rescues us from our sins. Now, you're going to hear more about this next week as we celebrate a couple of very special times in the year called Good Friday and Easter. But now, it's time for you to stand up and sing to our wonderful God. Go on, stand, little ones. Stand like you've never stood before. Until next time, I'm Game Show Ricky, and this was the Review Report.
y'all put some mini eggs in my ice cream. That was really sweet. Game Show Ricky was a big help, don't you think?
Well, yeah, that was. But, I mean, now I just want mini eggs and ice cream.
That would be delicious.
Oh, well, that was such a great way for us to rewind our brains and to remember some of the wonderful things we've learned on God's big story so far.
Now we're all set for our extra special episode next week, which has to do with why we celebrate Easter.
Oh, Easter, man, that Easter is going to be so good. Easter is such a great time of celebration, even though it kind of starts off a little sad, doesn't it?
Well, it does, but it gets real good real quick. But no more spoilers about that for now. The boys and girls will have to come back next time to hear more about Easter.
Okay, well, why don't you pray for us, Pastor Carl, and thank God for all we've been able to do on Kids Church TV so far and today.
For sure. Let's pray, boys and girls. God and Heavenly Father, we love you and thank you for your word, for all the amazing stories that you've given us to learn about you and how much you love us and how much you care for us. Would you help us, Lord, to love you back and to worship you with our lives? Thank you for loving us. Help us to love you more. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right, boys and girls, that's all the time we have for today.
We're so thankful that you were able to be with us on this special Rewind and Rejoice episode and go over all of the things that we've learned from God's big story so far.
And until we see you again, remember that God loves you.
See you all next time right here on Kids Church TV.